So there has been a lot of back and forth between Sean O'Malley and Adrian Yanez ever since Yanez' fight this past weekend against Davey Grant. And I saw something about it again today, pretty much O'Malley doubling down saying that he does want to fight Yanez in March, which this fight is definitely a very interesting matchup. I do kind of agree with Yanez because Yanez was saying that it's kind of weird that O'Malley should be calling out people that are ranked ahead of him, and instead he's calling out someone that's really kind of like ranked behind him. But I would definitely watch this fight if the UFC booked it. It's definitely a fun fight. You have two rising prospects, two very, very good strikers. I feel like this would be a weird one though for the UFC to book, because I feel like on one hand this would be a very fun fight that you could easily sell to fans, but on the other hand this would be a fight that you have two prospects you'd probably much rather see fight at the top, whether it be for title contention or when one's champion, one's challenger. Nonetheless though, this is a fun fight to break down. You have Yanez, who I would say is definitely more of like a boxer, a very fundamental guy, does a lot of fundamental things, throws good combos, has good physical attributes with speed, timing, power, all that good stuff. Doesn't really throw too many kicks. I mean, he did, I think it was like his first or second fight in the UFC, knocked out Randy Costa, I believe, with a head kick. So he does have that threat with his kicks, but he's not really known for that. He's not like an O'Malley where you're gonna be seeing a lot of crazy weird kicks. Like O'Malley, on the other hand, you're gonna get a very good physical striker. He's gonna be fast, he's gonna have the timing, the speed, the power, pretty much everything that Yanez has. But O'Malley's gonna have the physical size, he's gonna have the reach. I think he's gonna have a 2-inch reach advantage. He's gonna be significantly bigger. O'Malley is 5'11", where Yanez is 5'7". So in theory, it would be easier for O'Malley to keep Yanez at range. In terms of preparing for this fight is where things get tricky, because if you're O'Malley, it's definitely a lot easier to find somebody that can mimic Yanez's style, which is a lot more fundamental, versus Yanez, he's gonna have to find somebody that can mimic O'Malley, who O'Malley, like we all know, does a lot of weird, unorthodox things, throws a lot of crazy combos, like a spinning back fist into like a spinning roundhouse kick. It's like all the weird herky-jerky movements. You're not gonna get somebody that can easily mimic the same style like you could get for somebody like Yanez. That alone would definitely make things tricky for Yanez. O'Malley's definitely got a very weird style. He's gonna have a lot more attacks for Yanez to worry about, where O'Malley's really probably only gonna have to worry about the hands from Yanez. There's gonna be all kinds of different crazy attacks coming from different angles, and O'Malley's gonna be cutting different angles, cutting them off. I feel like this is a very good fight though for Yanez, for us as fans in the UFC, to really kind of see where he's at and gauge where he is, because he's gonna have to be able to get inside on O'Malley. He's gonna have to use his combination, his footwork, to get inside and land shots on O'Malley. Whereas for O'Malley, I feel like all you'd really have to do is just kind of keep Yanez at range, throw a bunch of different attacks, keep him guessing, and just use that size advantage, that reach advantage, and just completely outpoint him. Personally, asking me when I break this fight down how I see this fight playing out, I actually feel like this would be a pretty easy fight for O'Malley, and I feel like maybe that's why he's calling him out, because I feel like O'Malley would just have to do what he does, do what he's done to everybody else, just keep him at range. I feel like Yanez would probably be more of like a Chris Moutinho kind of guy, where he's going to take the damage. I don't really know if Yanez is going to get knocked out like O'Malley does to a lot of other people. I feel he could be able to take the damage and keep coming and keep trying to land shots, but I feel like just the sheer size advantage would really make things difficult for Yanez. Sean O'Malley's style blends very well with having a size advantage, so I feel like it's just going to play into his favor, and I feel like this would honestly be a very easy fight. I feel like Sean would probably win this no problem, but nonetheless, so I would definitely want to see this fight if the UFC does potentially book this. Now, O'Malley does have a fight December 11th against Hallie and Pavia, so he really doesn't have anything. He has no business worrying about a fight with potentially Adrian Yanez. I'm curious though, how do you guys see this fight playing out? Would you guys even want to see this fight booked? And if this fight does get booked, who do you guys see winning? I hope you guys did enjoy this video though. If you guys did, please be sure to drop a like, share this video if you guys know anyone else that would enjoy my type of content. The support, the likes, everything you guys do that's completely free is invaluable to me, and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. Like, comment, and subscribe. Till next time, I'll catch you guys later.